Ben Marco at the 10th anniversary Stories from the Golden Age event, here to give you the scoop on all the talent walking down the red carpet. So stay tuned.
Tonight we are celebrating the 10th anniversary for the Stories from the Golden Age, which is a series of books and audiobooks that were written originally in the 1930s and 40s, and they were re-released in 2008. We've sold since then 2.7 million copies of the series. They're very popular. We've done over 500 live theater performances across the country and abroad, and so we're just going to be doing a show tonight, Spy Killer. It's one of the stories that we want launched with in 2008.
What an accomplishment. I mean, 10 years. Like, this is the anniversary. This is the celebration. I just can't wait.
So what made you want to be a part of, like, some sort of production like this radio play or some sort of performance in this regard?
I think radio theater is really exciting. The actors involved are so talented. And I've actually been performing at this theater for many years.
Well, you know, I'm a voice guy. I've done animation and stuff for Jib Jab and Marvel. And, you know, you probably talk to these guys. We're people that love to do characters vocally. We're very interested in that. We're the kind of kids that had tape recorders when we were growing up, and we made our own radio shows. So, but by the time we grew up, radio was gone. There was no radio drama particularly. And so when I had an opportunity to direct these wonderful pulp fiction stories from the 30s and 40s by L. Ron Hubbard, I was very drawn to it because the characters are all larger than life.
I get to play characters that I would never be cast for,
That's right. You know? Uh-huh.
It opens the casting possibilities and your chance to, like, dive in and play some really fun characters that, you know, are larger than life and exciting, and I love that.
Oh, radio's fantastic because the audience gets to participate so much in their own creation of what they're hearing. They get to have their own pictures, they get to put in what they see. It's not, you know, well, that's what you have to see. You know what I mean? It's like, this is the image. No, you have your own images, and it can be pretty spectacular.
On stage, you're moving. You can move. And when you're recording, you have to be animated a little within more.
I was always also a big science fiction fan. That's how I got to know Hubbard's work originally. And so... When I suddenly realized that I was actually going to bring life to some of the stories that I enjoyed when I was growing up was just a great, great blessing. So it's been a wonderful experience.
Do you have any sort of advice or, like, words of wisdom that you can pass along?
Absolutely. Training. Training, number one. Make sure that you get the best training possible. And be persistent, I think, and keep your eye on the mountain. And enjoy the journey.
Embrace your passion, you know, just really, you know, work at it. It's hard work, and if you love it, then you don't mind the hard work, and just keep pursuing it, and think big, dream big, and, you know, just get yourself a game plan and go after it.
And that wraps it up here tonight for us on the red carpet. With The Scoop, I'm Ben Marco.
Fight on.
Fight on.
Fight on.